What's going on, guys? Patrick here with Drone Nerds. Today we're taking a look at some DJI Spark footage, Final Cut Pro X. I'm going to show you the exact process that I use to import, export, color correct DJI Spark footage, and the process of getting it into the editor, getting it out, getting it right to YouTube, and showing you the exact settings of everything and how the quality looks so good on YouTube and what you need to do to get the best quality out of your DJI Spark. Importing footage is simple. You're going to import footage just like normal off of the SD card. Once you import it, it'll show up here in the Finder. I shot this footage on Sunday. We were out in Miami on the boat doing some cruising around Key Biscayne, and you can see the footage looks amazing already. So what can we do to make it look even better? Well, first off, the thing I like to do is I'm going to import this onto my timeline. Make sure that you put this to 30p. If you put it to 29.7p, you'll have issues. And that's one of the things that I found when I was importing footage. I was importing it and putting it on the timeline at 29.97, and then when I put it on YouTube, it was kind of glitchy and did weird things. So make sure you put it to 30p right there. I have 1920 by 1080 and I'm using ProRes 422 codec there. I'm going to import that onto the timeline right there. So once I have that set up on the timeline, every other clip as well will be set up already with that codec and now the timeline set up. Got a couple clips. I'm going to put it on the timeline there if I want to put a song. I have three clips on the timeline now. I'm using the simple just auto exposure on the Spark in the DJI Go app. Just put it to auto exposure. You can put it to manual if you want, but I've just been using auto exposure. It works. It's fine. It's easy. You can see it looks amazing. It's great. Really in sunny conditions, no problem. For white balance, I'm using a sunny white balance in all of this footage. And there's no other options. Like, I can't adjust the custom settings or any kind of color profile. It's just what it is with the DJI Spark. Not much you can do. But overall, you can see the quality of the footage looks great. You know, a couple things that I like to do. I'm gonna bump up a couple different things here. I'm gonna add a couple filters to this. You can see I'm gonna go over here to color correction. I'm gonna add a color correction filter there. I'm gonna go into the color correction. I'm gonna add some saturation just to bump it up, give it a little bit more of a surreal look. Really pop those blues out. You can go crazy there. You can see all the way saturated there. It's a little too much, so I'm going to pull it back down here to about 20%. And then here on the exposure, I'm going to actually pull down my blacks a little bit. That'll give it a little bit more contrast, maybe bump up a little bit the midtones, and then I'm going to bump up here on exposure, or I'm going to pull it back depending on the clip and the exposure overall, but I can adjust. It looks pretty good like that. It's pretty close to perfect right out of the camera, but if you want to adjust it a little bit of fine tune, you can do that. You can also add some LUTs if you want to get crazy. If I add the LUT there, I can add a couple different LUTs. You can see here, it gets really crazy quickly. It's not gonna do much, because like I said, this footage is pretty much done right out of the camera. There's not much you can do, it's not many options, but you can get crazy with different LUTs and you can add stuff on there. Really get creative if you like. You can see that looks pretty cool actually. So there are options, there's things you can do. You can get crazy if you like, but overall the footage looks pretty amazing right out of the camera. This drone is the size of my hand. It's a small, little, tiny drone that shoots amazing 1080p footage. I got this clip here. If I want to do the same thing, I'm going to add some color correction there. Go into the color correction, pop that on there and bump up the saturation. A little bit of saturation there. Maybe pull the blacks down a little bit, just add some contrast there. And actually maybe pull down the exposure and the highlights a little bit there and bump up the midtones. For exporting for YouTube, I'm going to go file. I'm going to click share, go to master file. And then this is kind of the secret sauce. And then when I go to export, I'm gonna export H.264. YouTube loves H.264 footage. I don't know why, but it just really looks good on YouTube. You're gonna put H.264. You have a couple options there, but H.264 works great for me. Video, audio, and then I'm gonna click next. It's going to export. And then I'm gonna upload this right to YouTube. High quality 1080p footage from the DJI Spark. A little bit of color correction. You can add all kinds of different LUTs and get crazy if you want. Check out some of the clips that I shot the other day on Sunday in Miami with the DJI Spark. Stay tuned for more videos coming soon from Drone Nerds.